I have two brothers and a sister and a mother and a father who taught us that we should all love one another. And we go to church on Sunday in a little green Hyundai, have some grape juice and crackers, then we start again on Monday. And it's all fine and it's all well. I really want to find what I believe for myself. Because when you're gone and I'm still here, I want of you to tell me that I should be.
All right, we're looking at sources C and D for this video. So it very much parallels our video on the city-state of Sparta. But now we're looking at the city-state of Athens. So Athens was another huge and important city-state, and we're looking at the culture on source C. And there's some text and there's an overview video, and that is to be read, and the question is to be completed on Thursday, April 23rd of this week. And then source D, life in Athens, talking about the societal roles and education, just like we did about Sparta. That's going to be for Friday, April 24th. Again, a small question in Canvas that holds you accountable to your reading. But I'm going to read for you right now. Source C, Athenian culture. The people of Athens were able to trade for the things they needed. They could spend less time working and could focus on cultural pursuits. Athens became the center of culture. Athenian artists created like-life statues. They made pottery and decorated it. They wrote plays, they danced, they played music, they designed elaborate temples and other large buildings. Philosophers in Athens debated and discussed important ideas at the time. The climate of debate and discussion was part of the Athens democratic system. All citizens were expected to play a role in government. They all needed to be aware of the important issues of the time, whether they were leaders, right? This isn't in the text, or the people who voted or had some say in what was happening in the government. They wanted them to be involved. Huge part of their culture. Life in Athens, societal roles. Much of the daily life of Athens centered on the business of trade and the arts. Men took care of the daily responsibilities of their business and their homes. They shopped at the markets. Men also spent much of their time meeting in the public squares to discuss business and politics. The men of Athens had free time because enslaved people took care of the crops and of the homes. Because the men took care of most of the business outside of the home, the women of Athens rarely went into public spaces. They were expected to stay home. They were expected to do chores and to raise the children. Part of the children's education was to learn about these roles. And if you guys know anything about like old-time theater, whether in England or in Greece, the women roles were even played by men. A little strange, but definitely something of note with these societal roles. Education. Maybe hear Ella and Maya in the background. Here we go. Boys were taught to read and write and to take part in cultural life. As they grew, they became traders, artisans, and merchants. They actively participated in the culture and politics of Athens. When a boy reached 18 years of age, he took the oath of citizenship. He became a full participant in the daily life of Athens. Girls had fewer choices and opportunities. They did not go to school. They stayed home. They were taught by their mothers how to keep the home and raise the children. Even though their ability to participate in government was limited, women were important to the religious life of Athens. They could become priestesses. They often led the daily religious ceremonies that took place in the city-state. Again, hopefully these read-alouds help you to think about the questions, think about what you're reading, to take the edge off a little bit, and you know, quite frankly, just to interact a little bit with me and with the text in a different way. Have a good one, guys. I need you. Who do I call? How do I know I'll get through?